We are on step 11. That means we're almost done. We have 12 steps. This is step 11. And this one is a really, really easy step. So what we're going to do is, now that we've done our intensity transformations, we're happy with the way this looks. Yay. It looks nice. It's gotten darker. It's gotten more contrasty. Yay. Okay, we're ready to go. We are going to get our stars back into this image. So I have a handy dandy thing called Blend RGB Stars. And really what it does is take the narrowband image and blend it with the RGB image. You remember RGB image? We did that in step 5. That was a long time ago. So you could see we're going to blend this image with the RGB stars into this image. So that should be a lot of fun. But before we do that, what we want to do is take the narrowband stars, which we had before, and let me just minimize this a little bit. And what we're going to do is extract a luminance layer from them. So let me just find this luminance. I think this is luminance right here. Okay. So there's the luminance for this image. I extracted a luminance for these narrowband stars. And I'm going to take that luminance image and I'm going to apply it onto the RGB image. So let me just do that. Let me see. So we do that. So we're going to go through to color spaces, LRGB combination, just like we did when we had it aha as luminance. This time we're just going to add the NB stars and look at it. It's already selected. It knows it's a luminance image. We're actually going to just keep this at 0.5. We might, in this case, want to go into the channel weights and keep this at maybe a 0.75. I don't like to go too far with this luminance layer. I don't know why. Sometimes I feel like it just wipes out the color of all our stars here, and I don't really like wiping out that color. You know, now that I'm looking at this RGB image, I realize I never stretched it. So, oh my God. So let's just do a quick intensity transformation, or should I say a histogram transformation to this. So I'm going to go into, I was wondering why it looks so weird. I was like, this doesn't look right. So I'm going to go into histogram transformation here just to stretch the RGB image. I'm going to move over my NB star. So let's kind of put that aside for now. Let's select the RGB and let's hit right there. And I'm also going to turn off the screen transfer function just like we did with our other ones. Okay, I'm going to move this over. And the fun part about this is I don't want to stretch this so far where, you know, you lose this color of the stars. So you want to keep the color of the stars. Like the screen transfer one, that's why I thought it looked weird, was because the color of the stars were starting to get a little unsaturated, I guess you could say, or they don't look very colorful. Maybe that's the nicer way to say it. It doesn't look very colorful. Okay, so let's go over here. Again, you never want to go too far. This one is very, very delicate. When you're doing this, you got to be very, very nice to it. You don't want to go too far. The RGB in particular, because you want your stars to be saved. You want to keep the color in them. You don't want to go too far with this one. Okay. But you want to go far enough, right? All right. I think that's it. That's about as far as I want to go. This is a very delicate image. And I have my RGB here. I still have beautiful colored stars here, you know, or at least I think I do. They're somewhat beautiful. I wouldn't say they're the most beautiful looking stars ever. But the whole point of shooting RGB is to get those RGB stars. So let's go back to our process of, what was this? What were we doing? Narrowband or LRGB combination? So we're going to go to color spaces, LRGB combination. We're going to bring that up again. We already got our NB stars luminance layer here. And I established that I only want to do about 75% of the channel weight. And I don't want to do any saturation here. Definitely check off the chrominance noise reduction. And this is really a lot of trial and error. You want to kind of see what this ends up looking like. So I just applied it and we'll be right back. Okay, so we're out of that and we are back. Now, let me just make sure that we are maintaining some star color here. Yeah, I think we are. I feel like these are still kind of pretty. You know, they're not terrible. They didn't turn all white. They still got some kind of color to them. That's important because that's what we want. We want RGB stars that have color. And, you know, some of them are warm, some of them are whiter, some of them are. So, yeah, it makes it all interesting. Look at this. This one over here is like a little purple. So yeah, that's what's important. We want to maintain that color in the RGB stars, because narrowband stars in general are just ugly, right? They're just like white or something. So I think we're ready. Let's open up this blend RGB stars again, which I'm going to leave in the video down below. And, you know, you got to make sure your images are named properly. This is NB. This is RGB. You can see that I named them properly over here already. And basically what I'm going to do is just replace the target image, which means I'm going to drag this in right here and I'm replacing it. Look at that. Woo. All right. We got our stars back in, and they're colorful stars. They're RGB stars. Look at these stars. They're beautiful. I love them. You know, I wouldn't do all these extra steps of shooting these RGB stars if I did not think it was worth it. And it's definitely worth it. It's worth it. So yeah, that's all I got to say. Okay. Wonderful. We're there. That's it. RGB stars in, stars in. We're going to go to our last step, which is just really final touches and trying to make this image as best as it could be. It's kind of like the cherry on the cake, right? Cherry on the cake. That's what we're going to do. That's our last step. I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.